BTC will maintain this bullish market momentum in long term for the next post BTC halving, which is starting from April 2024. Okay, so we can gradually confirm that BTC markets going to be bullish in long term, Okay. Hi, hello, I'm Samasa. So here's the regular item, Bitcoin weekly forecast and macro updates from April 3rd to April 9th. Okay, so let's start. Then this is my portfolio performance as of now. So total return since March 2019 is 559%. Then if you're interested in much more detailed information about my portfolio allocations and also my real-time buy and selling signal for every single crypto asset, including ICO, IDO, DeFi, and NFT, please think about to join my premium membership program, real-time buy and selling signal. The major purpose of this membership program to help you reach your crypto asset performance to my level here. For more detail, please check out my video. Then here's my video link, okay? Then let's start here, Bitcoin, okay? So the same content since 3 weeks ago. Finally, we might see the decoupling of crypto assets from traditional assets, all right? Because of, you know, banking industry crisis in a global basis, okay? So I still closely pay attention to this topic here, okay? Then based on this understanding, we're going to move to BTC USDT daily chart. Okay. The first of all, you know, currently the BTC price is struggling around thick blue trend line. Okay. As you can see here. Then in the short time basis, also, you know, Fibonacci retrace based one around 1.618, price is around 28K, $615 or so will be functional like, you know, resistance line. Okay. Then for the next move, still, I think we have one more chance for the bridge line, but it's not for 100%, okay? One more chance. Then one more reason why do I think so is look at the number one, as I mark here, red circle. Based on the previous blue line, price is hit 1.618 in a Fibonacci retrace based one. Price is around 25K, 219. Okay, this is in a fast bridge line, okay? Then currently in the second bullish line. So based on the previous bullish line, 1.618 is around 31,283 as I mark here in the second red circle. So considering the banking industry crisis currently happening right now, BTC will keep the same price range with this bullish line. It's kind of, you know, not so unusual thing. Right? So based on this understanding, to me, still, there is one more chance for the bridge line. Then, you know, current BTC price just stopped around 1.414. As I mark here in the blue circle, price is around 29,284. Then almost right before 1.618, Fibonacci retrace based one. That's why I still, you know, there is, you know, one more chance here. Then if you're going to see one more bridge line from here, my bottom out target, you know, after this price questions, will be around thick skyward trend line. Okay. Then if you don't see bridge line from here, my bottom out target is thick green trend line. Okay. That's my target. Then, you know, fundamental key support line for this is, you know, thick orange trend line. Okay. Then, same content since last week. So key news updates. So this is a monthly chart of the Bitcoin. Then RSI hit the bullish breakout against 50, almost half level here. Then in a previous bullish line over 10 years or so, once this monthly RSI hitting higher than 50, as I mark here, skyboard circles, Bitcoin never going back under 50. So they're gonna go into long-term bridge line. Only one exception is Corona shock. As I mark here, red circle. This is the only one exception, which means that, you know, as far as we don't see any kind of a similar type of, like, you know, serious travel like Corona shock, BTC will maintain this bridge market momentum in long-term for the next post BTC halving, which is starting from April 2024. Okay, so we can gradually confirm that BTC market's going to be bullish in long term. Okay. Then next one, WTI crude oil markets daily chart basis. Last week, as I mark here in the red circle, we're gonna see pretty much strong, you know, price jump, as you can see. Then why this happened? Please pay attention to this thick parallel green line around $60. The reason for this, you know, price jump is this one. OPEC announced the surprise production cuts of more than 1 million barrels a day. This is the reason for this. This means OPEC also seriously pay attention to this price level around 60. Okay, 60 barrels a day. Yeah, that's the things we can learn from here. Because, you know, all the time, this price level function like, you know, pretty strong support line. Multiple times, you're going to see price recovery from here. That's why. Kind of similar things happened here this time too. Okay, so to me, it's not so surprising things. This, you know, production cuts. Okay. Then next up, S&P 500 futures, daily chart basis. Then currently, as we know, you know, this short-term red line is functional like a key support line, key trend line. Okay. Then since, you know, EMA 200 is lower than candle bar price move, this is good. Okay. Then for the next move here, the key things we have to pay attention to is US inflation rates. April 12th on Wednesday, we're going to get the key updates from there. Okay. Then if you're going to see another drop, US inflation rates, I think S&P 500 index will go up to this thick bull trend line. Then also hit higher than this thick bull trend line. Then hitting upper price trend line, you know, red trend line. That's what I'm thinking about. Okay. So overall, still, you know, S&P 500 index keeping the bullish momentum. Okay. Then next one, US 10-year treasury interest rates, daily chart basis. So still the price is flowing, you know, this short-term bull trend line is a bear trend line, okay? But the gradually this bearish momentum is getting weaker. Why? Because look at the, you know, bull trend line. You know, middle line here, we're gonna see pretty strong price reversal actions, bridge line on last Friday, not the lower price trend line. This means market momentum gradually shifting from bear to bull. Okay? Gradually. That's the things we can learn from here. But, you know, to confirm this bullish momentum here, the candle bar move itself has to recover on top of this orange thick trend line. Thick orange trend line. Okay? Then it's on US inflation rates. So as I told you, this Wednesday, we're going to see the updates from March, okay? Then February starts with 6.0%. So if you're gonna see another drop from here, stock market goes bullish, okay? Then there's some US FFR by FRB. So last week, Fed hiked the interest rates 4.65. March was 4.57. Then their max cap set is currently 50%, okay? Then as I told you many times, I think Fed not gonna hike the interest rates higher than 5.0%. That's what I'm thinking about, okay? Because it's too risky for them, which accelerate, you know, these kind of interest hike higher than 5.25% will accelerate their recession. Will accelerate the recession risk of the US economy. That's why, you know, they're gonna keep the 5.0%, okay? The next one, US initial service claim, weekly updates, -19.84% last week. It's a pretty big drop. It's good news for, you know, US unemployment rate. It's pretty good. Okay. Then US unemployment rate, last week, we're going to get the updates for March, 3.5%, -0.1% from February, 3.6%. It's pretty good. Okay. Then next one, BTC transaction fee, 2.702. -10%, 7-day change. Kind of a steady move here, okay? Then next one, all market cap and BTC movement slides. Total market cap minus 0.3%. Okay, almost no change. But BTC dominant slides hit minus 0.81%. This means if you're gonna see one more bridge slam on the Bitcoin, some of the altcoin will hit much stronger bridge down than Bitcoin. That's the things we can learn from here. Okay. Then for our backup analysis, ETH BTC weekly chart basis. Okay. So as I told you many times, this thick blue trend line function like pretty strong support line. We're gonna see the pretty strong price reversal actions. Then April 12th, this Wednesday, also Shanghai upgrade. After this, I basically think Ethereum more bullish than Bitcoin. So this trend line is also following this price move here based on these fundamental updates. Okay. Then EMA 200 also lower than candle bar price move. This is also pretty good. Okay. Then next one, Google search trend. BTC minus 221, Ethereum no change, NFT plus 13, crypto plus 18. So as you can see, NFT and crypto getting bullish. Okay. Then from here, key news updates. Then latest key news. Doge soars after Twitter replaces its blue bird logo with the token's dog. You know, Shiba dog. So currently, as we know, that Twitter is 100% owned by Elon Musk, right? So, you know, he can do anything he wants. Kind of interesting, but you know, if he wants to apply the DAO operation model, it's not gonna acceptable, right? Okay. Then next one, upcoming US Bitcoin economy events. Next week, this Wednesday, April 12th, US inflation updates. It's pretty important for us. Okay, let's pay attention to this. Then from the, you know, 2 weeks later, you know, end of April to May, we're gonna see US major tech stock. Okay, I think probably most of like US major stock hit the little, you know, bearish move. That is why I see more price corrections on a US, you know, stock market side. That's what I'm thinking about. Okay. Then here's kind of last slide. So what's the key mindset at the HODLer? So most people believe that HODL is like a smooth scenario. That is why it's upside scenario, but the reality of HODL is downside scenario. So here's one key thing. So what I want you to pay attention to here, that if you want to gain bigger investment return in a crypto asset investment, be patient. Then here's the result of HODL. So I think the HODL is best for the retail investor to minimize the risk and maximize the return, because investment in Web3 assets, just like an investment in early days of Google and Facebook. Then once we can look at the legendary angel investor traction, such as Long Conway, Peter Thiel, Riedelman, all the time they're gonna take the simple investment approach. It's a long-term investment. Then here's another evidence for the Binance research. This is a Bitcoin case, and the longest hold of the Bitcoin also maximize the investment return. In this case, plus 220%, much larger than other short-term order here. I'm gonna also basically take the long-term investment approach. So I'm gonna also recommend you guys to take the same approach too, okay? All right, so that is all this time. So I'm gonna make this video for the educational purpose. So I'm not gonna guarantee you any kind of certain level investment outcome with this video or any video that I make. But I truly hope that my video probably help you guys understand about high potential about crypto and watching space. So I'm gonna make lots of interesting video crypto and watching space. So thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Bye.